Now, the last one I want to talk about is brown patch or Rhizoctonia. Now, this one I have seen. In my Zoysia, I had some spots earlier this season, and I have seen it in St. Augustine all throughout my neighborhood. I think I might have had one or two areas that got a little infected, but not too bad. You'll see those in videos if you go back into like January, February in my catalog. You probably see a couple spots I showed you that I got. But other than that, I haven't seen it, but I've seen it in a lot of St. Augustine lawns around my neighborhood here. However, I will tell you that turf-type tall fescue and Zoysia get affected the hardest or the worst or are the most susceptible in a lot of cases, followed then by St. Augustine and centipede. It also can get into rye and bluegrass. So this is one of those brown patch that can affect almost all of the grass types except for bahia grass. So the way you'll know brown patch is these irregular kind of splotches that show up. I mean, you got to Google pictures of it because it manifests a little bit differently in different grass types, depending how it moves. I've mentioned before, I'll see it move around by where water flows. And so the first thing is, if you think you have brown patches, I want you to get out and start taking pictures immediately. One of the things I've talked about with disease is your expectation on the recovery from the disease. And if you don't take pictures or have a history, all you're going to think is, oh my gosh, this looks bad every day. But if you have a history, if you've taken pictures, you will actually be able to see the progression. It's kind of like taking for granted someone that's beautiful after you look at them for long periods of time. Maybe they just don't look as beautiful as they used to. Boy, that's a terrible analogy. It can work the opposite with the lawn, though. It can look worse and worse and worse and worse and worse to you over time because all you notice is the bad. But in reality, it may actually be getting better. So if you do think, this goes for all the diseases, but especially with brown patch because of the way it moves and the way it progresses and because of the kind of severe quick damage that it can do, you want to start taking pictures of that right away. Now, I want to go back because I had mentioned this before when I talked about NC State and what they consider to be high nitrogen, but for sure with brown patch, if you have brown patch in your lawn, you do not want to apply nitrogen going forward unless it's in very low dose amounts because you don't want your entire lawn to go without any type of fertilizer. So you want to keep the amounts really, really low dose. And so here is what NC State says. If you have Rhizoctonia or if you think Rhizoctonia or brown patch may be a problem because this one overwinters. So if you get it this year, your chances are you're going to get it next year. Here's what NC State says when it comes to brown patch. Do not apply excess nitrogen when conditions favor disease development. In general, cool season grasses should not receive more than 1 pound of nitrogen per 1,000 square feet at any one time. So if you've been on my programs and you're in North Carolina and disease has been prevalent or could have come up and you're applying 0.75 pounds of nitrogen every 4 to 6 weeks all through the spring, you are fine. You did not break this rule. You did not do anything wrong. You did not cause your brown patch. You did not do anything to make it hit your lawn. So for the most part, when you have Rhizoctonia and brown patch in your lawn, just stop with the nitrogen fertilizer until it starts to go away. You can apply, though, micronutrients. You can apply sea kelp, humic acid, all the things we've been talking about primarily. And then you also want to apply some potassium. OO2 microgreen has that, I keep mentioning. And then with this one, you definitely want to do what you can to create air movement. Can you trim your trees? Can you get out with your blower and blow the dew off the lawn in the morning? What is it that you can do to help create some airflow? Because you're going to notice that Rhizoctonia is going to be in areas where the airflow is restricted, maybe with shade or dappled sun. Those are the types of things that can make it worse. So what can you do to help clear that out and get some airflow in there would be another one. And then for sure, your approach here, when it comes to fungicides, azoxystrobin and propiconazole, both together every 14 days using the curative rate. And you want to keep applying those liberally, I mean, as instructed on the label. And that can really help to slow that Rhizoctonia down, stop it, and help that lawn recover. Now, once it stops, once you notice that it isn't spreading anymore, which is why it's important to take these pictures, and things are starting to dry out. By the way, cloud cover also contributes to this. So once you get bright sunlight to help dry some of that out of there, then you can pick up your fertilizing again, but it's probably going to be midsummer, so you're not going to want to pick up too fast or too hard. You're going to want to go with low doses of nitrogen. But as always, you want to try to keep airflow in there. That's the key with Rhizoc, is to keep that airflow in there as much as possible. And then, of course, if there are any dead areas that are scarred that you want to help clear up faster just because it'll help you see some results, spray dethatch on the dead spots or on the diseased spots or on the scars, and that will help to eat up that dead grass. And keep taking your pictures and watch how fast the recovery happens. Okay.